Hello everyone, I Sayed Nawaz. I welcome back you to my YouTube channel Petroleum Universe. So in today's video we are going to see something regarding mathematics which is going to be appear in GATE in any branch. So this video I'm making this video based on request from my viewers. So let us quickly start what we will see in today's video. So in today's video we are going to see the first topic of mathematics, that is nothing but linear algebra. Even in that And what I mean to say is linear algebra consists of three topics which are nothing but matrix algebra, system of linear equation, eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So in today's video let us quickly see some basics regarding matrix algebra, which consists of the definition of matrix and types of matrices, and addition and subtraction rule of matrix, two matrices, equality of matrices, and at last scalar multiple of matrix, right? So let us quickly see the definition of matrix. So matrix is nothing but as I can read over here, a system of m and n numbers which may be real or complex if they are arranged in the form of an order set of m rows and n columns between this kind of brackets, then it is said to be a matrix, right? So let us see the example. Like I wrote over here, let us consider this series of A as the numbers, real numbers or complex numbers. So as you can see that they are arranged in rows firstly, and even they are arranged in columns, okay? So as I said you above, that if the numbers are arranged in set of m rows and n columns, then it is called a matrix, right? So here you can see I wrote M and N, which indicates you the order of matrix. Order of matrix is like it tells you that how many number of rows are there in the matrix or how many number of columns were there in the matrix. So here M is nothing but rows and N is nothing but the column. And over here I just wrote A I comma J, where I is the position of the row and J is the position of the column. Okay. So let us quickly see what does it mean. And over here I wrote one condition that I will be in between 1 to m and j will be in between 1 to n, okay? Right. So let us quickly jump for our next topic, which is nothing but types of matrices. So the first one what we have is square matrix. So without reading any definition, I can tell you that in matrix there will be equal number of rows and columns, although I wrote here I equal to j, so you can neglect that if you are considering I and j as the position of the rows and columns, or else if you consider the I and j as the number of rows and number of columns, then you can consider this equation to be correct, okay? But I am considering m and n as the rows and columns over here, so I should neglect this one, right? So as you can see in the equation, that in the example that a matrix of A, B, C, D is given over here. So you can see that we have two rows and we have two columns, right? So where number of rows and number of columns are equal, then that matrix is considered to be an square matrix, right? So I hope you understood this. Let us jump for a rectangular matrix, right? So in rectangular matrix, as the matrix name itself says that number of rows and number of columns were not equal to each other, right? So let us quickly see the example for it, like matrix of 1 2 3 4 5 6. So here over here we have two rows and we have three columns, you can see like that. So I wrote over here the condition, if you want to understand in these terms, m is not equal to n, or else I is not equal to j. What I can't say in my explanation means, according to me, if you consider I and j as the rows and columns, as I said before, then you can consider this example. Then for the next matrix, the next type of matrix is row matrix. So in row matrix, you can consider that if a matrix just have one row, either that matrix may be square or rectangular, then that matrix is considered to be a row matrix, okay? So you can see the example over here, that matrix of 1, 2 and 3, in this we have three columns as 1, 2 and 3, and one row like this. Like this we have one row, but we have three columns. So here it is like one row and three columns, where m is equal to 1 and n is equal to 3. So it is nothing but a row matrix, or you can also consider the next example as a matrix of 1 which has equal number of rows and equal number of columns. M and n were equal, so it is nothing but a square matrix. So if you jump to column matrix, another type of matrix, in this you can consider by name itself that it will be having only one kind of only one column. Okay, so the example is like 1 2 3, right? So here we have I wrote 1 into 3. So here we have three rows, like one row, second row and third row, but we only have one column, right? So here you can consider, here you can see that m is not equal to n, but n is equal to 1, right? Where n represent you the number of columns. Okay. So now let us see the next type of example, which is nothing but the unit matrix. Okay, so a unit matrix, a matrix where diagonal elements are 1. For example, a matrix of 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. So before saying this, let us see what the diagonal elements were. Okay, so the diagonal elements is like the position of a number where the position of the row is equal to the position of the column. As you can see over here, the 1, it is like it is at the position as first row and first column, where the next one is like it is at second row and second column, and whereas third one is nothing but it is on third row and third column. And apart from that, the speciality of unit matrix is like apart from diagonal element, each and every number will be 0. Okay, or you can consider that diagonal elements were non-zero. Okay, so let us jump for diagonal matrix. Like if you see the definition, a square matrix all of whose elements are 0 except diagonal elements were non-zero, right? So as I shown you over here that the diagonal elements were 1. If the diagonal elements were 1, then that matrix is nothing but a unit matrix. And if the diagonal elements are other than 1, okay, and rest of the numbers are 0, then that matrix is said to be a diagonal matrix. Okay, or else you may also get the question is like A is equal to diagonal of 3, 2, 2. Then you can simply write this diagonal matrix as like this, where this bracket indicates you that these are nothing but the diagonal elements. So 3, 2, 2, as I wrote like that, rest of the elements were 0. Okay. And consider that the diagonal matrix should be a square matrix. Okay. Right. So let us see the next one, diagonal elements of the matrix and principal diagonals. Right. So the diagonal elements in a matrix A is equal to Ai, j into order of m and n, the element aij of A for which I is equal to j. What I said before, that for example a11, a22 and a up to n, m comma n. Okay, so here a11 means, as you can see over here, a11 is 3 and a22 is like 2 and a33 as 2 only. Okay, so I hope you understood up to here, are diagonal elements of A. And the line along which the diagonal elements lie is called the principal diagonal. Right? So as you can see over here, it has in cross like 3, 2, 2. As you can see that these diagonals are in one line. Right? So that line is now said to be a principal diagonal elements, or principal diagonal of A. So now let us consider the scalar matrix. As you can see in the as you have seen above, that unit matrix is nothing but the diagonal elements are equal to 1. But in diagonal elements, in diagonal matrix, the diagonal elements can be anything, and apart from that, the remaining elements will be 0. Okay, the remaining numbers will be 0. But in a scalar matrix, as you can see the example, that the diagonal elements are equal but not equal to 1, equal to each other, and the rest of the elements are 0. So here you can even see the definition: a diagonal matrix whose leading diagonal elements are equal is called a scalar matrix, but apart from 1. Okay, right. Now let us see what the next next type of matrix is like: null matrix, or you can also say that zero matrix or empty matrix. So the name itself says that zero matrix means here all the elements were zero in this matrix. You can see the example as I wrote over here: matrix of 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Right? It has 2 rows and 3 columns, and all the elements are 0. Because of that, it is called as null matrix. So let us see the properties of null matrix. Is like, let us consider a matrix A. If you perform an addition operation with that to the matrix A with the null matrix, right? Then that will be equal to A. And if you do a vice versa, like if you add a null matrix with A, then even that also will be, if that matrix is equal to A, then that property is said to be, then 0 is an additive identity. Okay, so if sometime there is a question that what is an additive identity for 0, then you can write this particular condition: that A plus 0 is equal to 0 plus A is equal to A. If this is valid, then that is nothing but 0 is an additive identity. And the second property is like A plus of minus A should be equal to 0. Okay, that's a property of null matrix. Now we consider the upper triangular matrix. I like this kind of matrices. Let us see what is it. First of all, upper triangular matrix or triangular matrix should be a square matrix. So a square matrix whose lower of diagonal elements are 0. So what does lower of diagonal elements is like? The position of row should be equal to, should be greater than the position of the column. Okay, so let us see the example. Right. So as you can see over here, that this 0 is at second row and first column. So here row is greater than column, and over here it is like third row and first column. So even here the row is greater than column, and same like here, the row is greater than column, third row and second column. Okay, so as you can see over here that I made these zeros, that if this element of the matrix is 0, then that is said to be an upper triangular matrix. So you can see over here I wrote a note, and upper of elements may or may not be 0, and so diagonal elements also. Okay, so if you have a null matrix like this, okay, let us take this example for matrix. As you can see over here that these three elements were 0, and even these three elements are 0. So this matrix can also be say as upper triangular matrix or simply a triangular matrix, because we have for upper triangular matrix a condition is like the lower of diagonal should be equal to 0, right? So here you can see that the lower of diagonal elements are 0, and I wrote according to note this example is valid for it. Okay, so let us see for next example. So the next example is like a lower triangular matrix, a square matrix whose upper of diagonal elements are 0, that is ai comma j equal to 0 when I is less than j. Here I mean to say that every position of the column is greater to rows, and that element is 0. Okay, as it is denoted by L, and the upper triangular matrix is denoted by U. Okay, so let us see the note for it: diagonal elements and lower of diagonal elements are 0, or it may not be 0. Right, as you can see the example over here, that at this particular 0, the position of this 0 is nothing but second row and first column. So the column position is greater than the rows, and you can see like these two zeros, like this zero has in third column and first row, and this zero is nothing but third column and second row. So here these three elements are zero, then that this is this matrix is considered to be a lower triangular matrix. Okay, so let us see the next type of matrix, that is nothing but an idempotent matrix. Okay, so an idempotent matrix is a matrix where a square of a matrix is equal to itself, then that matrix is considered to be a idempotent matrix. So if you see an example, you can do by yourself that if you consider this a unit matrix of a order of 2 by 2, and the matrix is like a matrix of 1 0 0 1, if you multiply this matrix with itself, then it will give you the same matrix as it was before squaring or before multiplying with itself. Okay, or you can use this very good example like 2, -2, -4, -1, -3, -4, 1, -2, -3. If you multiply this matrix with itself, then it will give you the same answer as A. Okay, if you have that condition, then that is said to be an idempotent matrix. Okay. Now let us consider, let us see another example as involutory matrix. Okay, a matrix, if you do a multiplication of that matrix with itself, and if that multiplication gives you an unit matrix where it is denoted by I, you can see over here, then that matrix is said to be an involutory matrix. Okay, so the example for this is a very good example and very common, that is unit matrix of any order. You can consider 1 0 0 1, or you can use this example and do the calculation and do the multiplication or with the same matrix, then you will get an identity matrix of 3 by 3 order. So the example is like 4 3 3 -1 0 -1 -4 -4 and 3. Okay, so I hope you understood this matrix. So let us jump to another matrix, that nilpotent matrix. So here the nilpotent matrix is nothing but number of time multiplication to get a matrix as null matrix, as it is in simple definition, right? So let us see what I wrote over here. A matrix A is said to be a nilpotent of class X or index X if A or X is equal to 0 and A power X minus 1 is not equal to 0, and X is the smallest index which makes A power X is equal to 0. Okay, so if you see this example, A is equal to 1 1 3 5 2 6 -2 -1 -3, so this matrix will become nilpotent at the index value of 3. Okay, so if you do this calculation, then you will get that A power 3 is equal to 0 of this matrix, but A power 2 is not equal to 0 of this matrix. If you do calculation, you will even get this condition. Okay, so here you can write, here I even wrote that, and X is the smallest index which makes A power X equal to 0. Once you got after multiplication the final answer as 0, then consider that number as the index of that particular nilpotent matrix. Okay, so here after calculation you can see that A power 3 equal to 0, then you can consider A has an index of 3, or A has a class of 3. Okay, right, so let us see the next matrix is like equality of two matrices. So equality of two matrices means two matrices A and B are said to be equal if they have the same size and the respective elements of A matrix and B matrix are equal. Okay, so A i, j should be equal to A i, B i, j. Okay, right, so here if you see, I am considering that A equal to X, Y, P, Q and B equal to 1, 2, 3, Y, then I am saying that A and B are said to be equal, then what will be the value of X, Y, P and Q? Then simply, if I am saying that these matrices are equal, then X equal to 1, as you can see the corresponding element for X position is in the next matrix is 1, and for Y the corresponding position is 2, and for P it is 3, and for Q it is y, where y value is 2. Okay, so here if you got this equality rule, then that is very easy actually. Okay, so now let us see what will be the addition of the matrices. So here I wrote the word compatible. Okay, so whenever any operation for any particular matrices is possible, then that two matrices are said to be compatible to each other. Like I wrote over here, the addition of matrices, the addition of matrices is compatible only if they have exactly the same size, say m into n, right? So for doing addition, it is necessary that both the matrices should have the same size, then only the addition is possible. So let us see the example for it. Like A equal to, I wrote over here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and B equal to 5, 6, 7, 8. So as you can see here, the order of this A matrix is nothing but 2 by 2, and the B matrix order is also 2 by 2. Okay, so over here I wrote a simple operational rule for A plus B is A plus B is equal to AI comma J plus BI comma J, right? Where I of A matrix should be equal to B, I of B matrix. So here you can see that the position of the row of first matrix is 1 and column is 1, that I am multiplying with the row and column of matrix B as position 1, like 1 plus 5, and the remaining I am doing as like same, and I have done the first one, right? Like for this one, it is first row, second column, and same as in the B matrix, C is considered to be a first row, second column. So 2 plus 6, 3 plus 7, and 4 plus 8. So that's the rule of A plus B, that 6, 8, 10, 12. So it has a 2 by 2 matrix. So remember that in addition, if you're performing an addition to two matrices, then the order of the resultant matrix will be same as the two matrices. Okay, right. So let us see the properties of matrix addition. So matrix addition is said to be commutative if A plus B is equal to B plus A. So you can consider that every two matrices, if they are performing an addition operation, then that two matrices are commutative to each other. Okay, like you can see over here, if you perform B plus A here, then it will be same as resultant matrix. But remember that all the elements in matrix A and B should be positive. Okay, if one of the element in both the matrix is negative, then this rule cannot be applied to that matrix, right? Okay, then the next rule is matrix addition is associative, where the condition is like, first I have to do an addition operation to A and B matrix, then the resultant of this matrix, if I'm adding with the C matrix, if the resultant of this complete matrix is equal to the resultant of this complete matrix, then that three matrices are said to be, or the matrix addition is said to be an associative matrix. Okay, right. So let us see the third property, like the existence of additive identity is like, if A matrix is doing an addition operation with null matrix, and if that the resultant is get as the same matrix as A, then that set then matrix is said to be an additive identity. Okay, so let us see the next one is existence of additive inverse. Like over here you can see that minus A plus A is equal to 0, and it will be equal to A plus of minus A. So simple it is, and actually it is a very simple rule, that if you are subtracting A from negative of that A, then obviously it will be equal to 0, right? Okay, so if that is possible, then that matrix has a property of additive inverse. So why I am showing you these kind of properties is like they are asking in gate exam, like properties of matrices. Okay, so let us see the subtraction of two matrices. Subtraction is two possible means subtraction is very easy. It is nothing but what I showed you in the last property, this one. So here the minus property, what I mean to say is the rule of the subtraction of two matrices is as same as the addition of two matrices apart from its property. So here I wrote one note that subtraction of matrices is neither cumulative nor associative. So what is the rule of cumulative and associative? It is like A plus B equal to B plus A. So here in subtraction it cannot be possible that A minus B is equal to B minus A, right? And in the same with associative, if we are applying any negative sign, any negative operation to this complete matrix, then it will not be equal to the resultant of this matrix. So I hope you understood this point, right? So let us see the multiplication of a matrix by a scalar, right? So the definition says you that the M and N matrix obtained by a multiplying every element of the matrix A by K is called to be an scalar, right? So if you are multiplying any matrix with an element like K, then that matrix is said to be an scalar multiple matrix, okay? And it is denoted by KA. So let us quickly see an example, like A is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, then KA will be equal to, as you can see over here, that every element of the matrix is a multiple, now it's a multiple of K, right? So this matrix is called as scalar matrix, simple, scalar matrix, okay? So if you want me to make another video on this, because this is just a basic video, in the next video, if you want, I can explain you the rank of matrix and determinant and minor of matrix, okay? So if you wish so, then write in comment box that I have to make another video. So I hope you understood everything regarding this video. If you have any doubts or any question, then you can use my comment box. If you like this video, then hit share, like, comment and subscribe to my YouTube channel, Petroleum Universe. And please press the bell icon to get a latest notification of my videos. So that's it from my end today. I hope you enjoy it. So stay safe. Thank you.